Hi all, good day to everybody. So this is Menas and today I'm going to cook for you a very special recipe, but this involves oven also. I'm going to start cooking pizza. So today's recipe will be pizza and I will tell you what are the ingredients which are required for you to make this pizza. So you can take any toppings, but for me I have taken sausage from the sausage packet, and I have some mushrooms, and for the toppings I have capsicum and onions. So I have this base, I have the pizza base, but you can also make the base from the flour and you can use it. But the pizza sauce, I'm going to make it myself because it gives a lot of taste to the pizza. I don't believe in the ready-made pizza sauce, so I will make the pizza sauce myself. The ingredients which are required to make the pizza sauce is that you need two tomatoes, but these are small, so I have taken three tomatoes, and I have cut one full onion, and I have some oregano. So you need oregano, sugar, then you need sauce, 1 teaspoon of sauce, and some garlic. So with this I think we can start with our pizza sauce. So you can cut the tomato into 4 and just put it into the mixie. So mixie is here, and also the onions. And I have cut 5 pieces of garlic. So I'm taking some little bit of ginger garlic paste. So this sized ginger garlic paste is enough. So I'm going to add a little bit of water. So I have kept the mixie and I'm going to turn it into the After the mixture has grind nicely, you can see the sauce is like this. You can taste it also, and if you want you can add some salt. Now I'm heating the pan and adding some olive oil so that we have to take the raw taste of the tomato, so that is very necessary for a very good pizza sauce. I'm going to wait until the pan gets hot, the oil is like really hot, and after that I'll put this mixture into the pan. Now the pan has heated nicely. Pour the mixture here. Now add some salt. Now I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of chili powder. This is Kashmiri chili powder, oregano, because oregano is an Italian herb, and it gives a very nice flavor because pizza is an Italian dish, so you can add oregano. I'm adding some brown sugar into this, very little bit of brown sugar, so that it gives a very nice flavor to the sauce. You can use this sauce for bread and butter also. You can have it for bread toast and for other purposes also, like for your Maggi, because this is your homemade sauce. If you really want to add tomato sauce, you can add, otherwise this will do. But I'm adding a little bit, like 1 teaspoon of tomato sauce, because you know tomato sauce has that you know thickening agent, so you get a nice thick sauce. Just 1 teaspoon is enough, and give it a nice saute this nicely, so that you know Now the sauce is thickening. So do this for another 2 minutes. Alright, so the water has drained off the sauce completely. So in this sauce, just taste and see. But if you feel like it's okay, like it's very nice, you can take it. But if you want a really good spice, you can add some more chili powder in this. But for me, I tasted this and I felt it is the exact thing which I wanted. If you require, you can add 2 chili, you can add 2 chili flakes also into this. Now I'm going to take this mixture and going to spread out in the pizza base. You can make this base at home also, but I got this ready made. To make the base, it's very very easy. You have to take some all-purpose flour and you have to just make a dough and make it into a pizza base. I will just, if I get the recipe, I've never done this, but if I get the recipe, I will post in the description box. So this pizza sauce is very very good and a must try than the ready-made pizza sauces. If you really want, market pizza sauce, I would recommend you to try this ginger pepper sauce or cheesy sauce or the mustard sauce. You can try adding into this mixture, but I would really prefer to keep this raw because this sauce is one of the best homemade ingredients. So I have spreaded the sauce evenly over the base and now I have some chopped cheese, I have chopped this with this. So this scraper, I have chopped the cheese and now I'm going to add this cheese over this and I have to spread evenly as I did with the same sauce. Don't add bulk of cheese in one area and leave the rest. That looks very odd, right? So we have to add evenly. If you want a cheese burst pizza, you can add more amount of cheese, but the toppings should be less. But I'm going to put a lot of toppings, so I have kept the cheese less. So now I'm going to have some mushroom here. So I'm adding some mushroom. Spread out this toppings evenly. Keep it to any corners to add some color. Now I'm adding capsicum. Now I'm adding sausages. People who are vegetarian can add paneer. And I'm adding some onion because I'm adding a lot of topping, as I said before. Because of that reason, I have kept the cheese less. So as I started preparing these pizzas at home, I started to understand that with the ingredients which we buy, we can make a lot of pizzas at home rather than getting it in a hotel, because we are paying more and the toppings are very less. Here I'm adding a lot of toppings, so our nutrient amount is also a lot more. Yeah. And also in restaurant pizzas, you can see that the sausage is also very very less. So I like to keep in a lot of sausage because I love these sausages. So now my pizza is completely overloaded, but actually you can keep a less amount of toppings if you really want, but as I said, I love to keep in a lot of sausages. I have added a lot of sausages and as well as have added more mushrooms and onions and capsicums. But if you really wanted to keep it simple, you can keep it, but the nutrient content is more in this, so I would like to have a plate full of spread it out toppings. Now I have kept this into the microwave, so it looks very delicious in that lighting. So now I have put the settings and the microwave will cook this pizza for almost 8 minutes. So I'm giving start. Now the microwave started and the pizza is cooking inside. So meanwhile, I would like to show a setup in which people who don't have microwave, you can use this setup to cook your pizza. So this is this setup. You have your cooker, right? So people who don't have a pan which has a size of the cooker, you can place some a little small vessel, and over that you can place the pan, and you can spread some salt and water, then place that vessel and place the pan, and after that you can keep in the pizza. But now I have a pan which has the length of the cooker, so I'm keeping this above. So once I have the pizza, I can keep the pizza here and I can put this like this. So this is the cooker setup, I mean the oven setup. So for people who don't have oven, please don't leave trying pizza. In this, definitely you'll get a very good baked pizza. But make sure that in this pan you put some ghee, because sometimes the base might stick to the pan. So put some ghee and spread it all over the pan, and then place the pizza. I have tried this setup once and it worked out beautifully, so I suggest you all to try this setup. Make sure the pizza is in between and cook this for almost 15 minutes. For oven, I have kept for 8 minutes, but for you know, this setup, you can have it for like 15 minutes. Now the time is 5 minutes more for the pizza to come out. Still inside cooking. 3 minutes more, so I'm starting to get a very very good flavor of the pizza, the sausage flavor. It shows that it is a sign that the pizza is cooking nicely. Now we can see that the pizza is cooked, so has baked nicely and ready to take it out. Wow, the pizza is cooked nicely and beautifully. So I have this roller which is used to divide the pizza into 4 pieces, and you can also have this roller or you can use a knife. So the pizza is ready. I'm ready to eat. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Kindly subscribe to my channel to know more videos on motivation, cooking and more information. Thank you for watching, and leave your comments in the comment section. Thank you guys. Bye bye.